خانوادهش انشاءالله برای پدر مادرش رو حفظش کنن، همچنین سایر فرزندان یکی که من شما رو بلندتر
the signified importance of tears that brings you a hadith, which I believe They are happy in this world. They will be mourning in this world. Drenched of the bread. I think the sanctuary in you was We have the birth certificate of our Imam. we make between you and the unbelievers and those who do not believe in the resurrection day, that do not believe in the life after death, we make a hidden barrier. There is a barrier. Hijab in the Quran means a hidden barrier, a hidden curtain. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes a curtain between the prophet and the unbelievers. And this curtain is hidden, unseen. You cannot see the curtain. So therefore, you cannot see the prophet, you cannot see the person behind the curtain. So these examples Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made, we have examples that has been done this kind of absence. So it doesn't mean when we do not see things that we do not exist. Do you see the viruses? They are there. Do you see the air or the wind? We do not see the wind, but we feel it. So do you see the angels? The angels exist, they are there. Do you see the ghosts? The ghosts are there. You can see them. You cannot see the ghost. Some people they can, or they have the ability of seeing the ghost. When we do not see the ghost, when we do not see some kind of animal, it doesn't mean that they don't exist, or they don't have any rule in this world. There are many, many animals and plants that they have a rule in this realm. They play important role in the existence and continuation of the existence of this realm. Do not know them. The angels, they are soldiers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, controlling this air and controlling everything in this air. They are managing things on this air, but we do not see them. So the things we do not see doesn't mean that they do not exist. So what is the benefit of having an absent imam? At the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Jabir ibn Abdullah Ansari, one of the best companions of the Prophet, because he heard from the Prophet that there will be a long period of time in which the Imam will be absent. He asked the Prophet, what is the benefit of having an absent Imam? The Prophet replied, كَالْشَمْسْ خَلْفَ الصَّحَابِ, like the sun behind the cloud. Look at the simile that the Prophet is given for an absent Imam. And you know that the Prophet doesn't say, whatever he says, it is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when he gives this kind of signal, when he puts a similarity between the Imam and the sun behind the cloud, there is a philosophy, there is a reason behind it. It is a real smile. It is not fake. It is not similarity. It is a real. What is the rule of the sun? Look at the rule of the sun. There are three points. There are three secrets behind the Prophet giving this example, that the absent Imam is like the sun behind the cloud. The first example, or the first secret, is that, as you know, the light of the sun is from itself. The Prophet didn't say the Imam is like the moon. Why? Because the light of the moon is taken from the sun, from another source. The Prophet wants to say the Imam has his own life, his own power, his own knowledge. Although this knowledge has been given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but he's not taking this knowledge from another person. So this is the first point. The Prophet wanted to send this message. The second message is that the sun has the central place and location in the universe. That the horizon and the Imam as well, his existence in the world, in the earth, has a central position. This is the second point. The third point is the most important point, that the sun, even though it is behind the cloud, but still all the people and whatever on there, not only the human, not only the mankind, even the plants, they get benefit from this light of the sun behind the cloud. So the light is continuing because of this, the light is continuing because of this light. behind the cloud? Yes, when the sun appears directly, when the sun shines directly on objects, of course the objects and the things will get an maximum benefit from the sun. But when the sun is behind the cloud, still the objects and everything get benefit from the sun. But of course, it's less than the benefits they receive directly from the sun. So this is the rule of the Imam. The rule of the Imam, the responsibilities of the Imam are many, many. We will count them, inshallah, in some other time, because we don't have a limited time. We have to seek discretion as well. So the responsibilities of the Imam, there are many responsibilities for the Imam. Some of them do not require his appearance. For example, protecting the faith. The Imam is protecting his faith. But he will not see that. He's doing his duty, he's doing his job. And there are some other responsibilities. This salawat is the shalat of the shirk. نسبة أهمية الدعاء صفات شرط الدعاء روح عبادته و هر عبادتی که انسان انجام میده گرچه داری از این عبادتها به طور صحیح در زبان دعا جاری نمیشه درخواست جاری نمیشه اما همان عمل عبادت اظهار ضعف و ناتوانی است و درخواست کمک از یک قدرت پنهان با خداست شما موقعی که نماز میخوانید یا موقعی که روزه میگیرید روزه گرفتن درش درخواست لفظی از خدا نیست دعا کردن لفظی نیست اما همین این عبادت خودش دعاست روحش دعاست یعنی شروعش درخواست کمک و درخواست نیرو از یک منبع نیرومند از یک قدرت لذا گفته میشود که دعا روح عبادته هر عبادت اصلا در آنگاه جدید حضرت رسول. در زمان حضرت رسول جعفر بن ابی طالب برادر حضرت علی رفته بود جنگ مهمه، یکی از جنگ‌ها که حضرت رسول حاضر نشده بود در این جنگ، بعد در اون جنگ شهید میشه. حضرت رسول در نسل با اصحاب نحوه شهادت جعفر رو تعریف می‌کرد، به گریه می‌کرد، به اشک می‌ریخت. اصحاب اشک می‌ریختند. ناگهان حضرت علی وارد مسجد شد. حضرت رسول در مورد اصحاب ساکت می‌شید، آروم می‌شید، چیزی را اظهار نکنید. داد برادر خیلی سنگینه. این برادر از دست داده، اجباری کنید که متوجه نشه که برادر شهید شد. حضرت وارد مسجد می‌شید، متوجه می‌شید که وضعیت مسجد و وضعیت مجلس طبیعی نیست. چهره‌ها مختلفه. پس پیغمبر سوال می‌کنه یا رسول الله، اتفاقی افتاده، چیزی شده؟ من برادر در سفر دارم، به برادری دارم که مسافرت، اگر تو کار افتاده بگید. رسول الله به برادر میگن یا علی، خدا صبر بدهد، برادر شهید شد. در اینجا حضرت علی جمله ای را فرمود. حضرت علی فرمود حسن من الله، یعنی کمرم شکست. در اون لحظه و اون وضعیتی که حضرت علی هم رسول خدا را داشت و هم اصحاب را داشت، با از دست دادن برادری که حضرت علی ندید چگونه از دست رفت و چگونه شد، در اونجا حضرت فرمود حسن الله. در صحنه کربلا علی عبدالله بودید چه مصیبت هایی و دل این مرد بزرگ وارد شد. این ویژگی های مصیبت هاست که باعث شده امام حسین این چنین گل کنه، به این چنین یاد او به این صورت برده میشه، به این چنین باعث شده که دین زنده بمونه تا قیامت. صحنه‌ای که در سر برادر آمد، برادرش رو با آن وضعه دید، دو دست بریده، در زمین افتاده، قلب شکافته. اینجا هم همون جمله رو تکرار الان انی کسر و اطلاق نمیدید آقا شکستن این کمر گویا و شکستن این کمر اینا رضا و اینا
Bye.